Hey, it's your buddy Peace and Harmony with you here today. We are picking up where we left off on the previous video on how to have the courage to go no contact from a covert narcissist, an overt narcissist, or a psychopath, or really a borderline, anyone who really presents with a personality disorder who tends to devalue and discard. It tends to distract you from your life purpose, your mission, your happiness. Things, your inner voice, your inner values, who you are, doesn't allow you to laugh. You know, the minute you begin to loosen up and let go, here comes the insults, here comes the barrage, and it's even worse than before. Or you're just feeling an inner void from this person. In other words, you've been so supportive, nurturing, and attentive to their needs, always constantly putting them first. You've given the basic valuation of service. And now it has done you a disservice because you have always put them above. You've put them on a pedestal. You've always been able to respect and value and honor this person. And to the extent that they became really the taker and not the giver. And the covert narcissist will enjoy and adore this type of relationship where you can constantly adore, support, honor, put them first, attend to their needs, even if it means you giving up your needs, subjugating your needs to the rung of the unimportant, living in denial, living in repression, and then always feeling like they are better than, and so it is always your approach to people and then into life, because this person has set the tone. This person has become so important to you in your life that they have set the tone for all your life and really how you approach other relationships. And so this effect of constantly putting other people first, valuing them more than you value yourself, becomes a very, very dangerous dynamic. And it keeps people stuck. It keeps people working too hard to keep a relationship going. So when I hear the people who write me and say, how do I go no contact? You know, how do I really do this effectively and efficiently? You know, I'm too afraid to do this. I can't. People tell me, you know, and then they're just exhausted, that they don't have the energy. They don't have the inspiration. They don't have the vision. They don't have the mission in their life. They don't have the time to take time for themselves. It is because they have gotten into a habituation where they and a really an identity of constantly putting others ahead of them, constantly valuing others more than they value themselves, constantly putting people pleasing ahead of self pleasing. There's an evil that they feel with living their own life. There's an error with embracing and loving themselves. They feel something is wrong if they are able to love who they are. They have been told that they're a failure. They've been told that there's something wrong with them. They have been shamed or provoked into anger so many times because they're around a borderline person who always wants to promote them into anger. Even though there's, you know, the few little supportive things that they give, it doesn't, you know, the outbursts don't, you know, the outbursts tend to blow up in their face. And it doesn't, the good is not outweighing the bad at this point. Basically, then, you know, the rage becomes what is so destructive. And, you know, you don't want to go through the recovery time of the fights and then the makeup, the fights and the makeup. And so the covert narcissist, as we're saying in the previous video, is kind of like the candy at the checkout line that ruins your appetite. So here you have, you know, your personality, your values, your life, the things that are naturally, you know, who you are. And if you were to tap into that and embrace it and live that, you know, life would be there to support you. But the narcissist is like the impulse buy at the checkout aisle where there's the candy. And, you know, you tend to fill your life up with pleasing them or that immediate, you know, you're just going for their hook. You've fallen into their trap to please them. And you've now, you know, filled, as I was saying in the previous video, it's as if your life is now filled with all sorts of things which have ruined your appetite for life. You have now, you know, you now are on a steady diet of people pleasing and doing things that are not positive for you, your life, your body, your mindset, and you're now exhausted. I think many people who write me, they're in this state. They're in this dejected state. They don't have the energy. They're so depressed. Their body, you know, their cellular metabolism has gotten to the point where they're feeling so dejected that they're receiving and sending a lot of these negative messages. You know, I'm so angry. I've wasted a lot of my time. I've wasted a lot of my energy, or I feel so alone. And you have to realize that feeling alone, you are negatively interpreting the fact that you need to value yourself. Valuing yourself is seeing that you are important and talented, and you have your own individual genius that is just waiting to shine, is waiting for you to basically shake off the dust and allow it to be, you know. But the fog, the fear, obligation, and guilt from, there's so much information here, that this person has projected onto you makes you feel like a dusty rug, you know, just dirty, tainted, not valued, not worthy. And it just, the dust tends to settle on people's lives, and they don't know how to pick themselves and shake themselves off. They don't know how to get the energy back, the valuation back. They don't know how to rehab their life. They don't know how to, you know, basically restructure things without this person. They've built their life around this person and how this person perceives them. And this can be at a society at large, where basically you're reinforced through triangulation, through a lot of the brainwashing. It is reinforced because there can be so many narcissists or people who buy into that mindset that make it difficult for you to think about, you know, think for yourself. And it almost, you know, is you have to embrace the fact that yes, you have to think for yourself and be for yourself. And that is the way, that is the life, that is the way to the divine, you know, however you want to call it. If you were to look at water for a moment, and this is how important it is. If you were to look at water, this is divinely created. This is the divine right here. There's only so much limited water in life, and no man has been able to recreate this. There's no, there is no laboratory that can create water. There's a limited amount. And you use this in so many ways. Your body is 70% water. The earth itself is 70% water. This is the divine. This is what is running through you, and it, oftentimes this is what people are negating within themselves. They're negating the divine that is within them. They're not realizing that they have their own way, their own channel, their own flow in life, where they are supposed to be going and embodying, and their life is stuck. They're not in the flow. Their thoughts are not flowing. Their values are not flowing. Their money is not flowing. Their voice is not flowing. They are stuck. They are saying, I am exhausted. It is because you have allowed your life to be turned upside down. Like we talk about real estate, which is upside down. You've allowed yourself basically like a piece of property to be put into a wrong area, you know, where it's devalued. As I was saying, you know, you can't bring... bring crystal into the ghetto, you know, where it's going to be devalued. Someone doesn't know, or you can't, you know, what's another example? You can't be gold and, you know, have someone tell you that you're copper. You know, someone is going to devalue you, and they're going to resonate with you in a wrong way. And so life is like a tuning fork. You will get what you harmonize along with. You hear about people who tune pianos, eventually, that's how the tuning fork will pick up the sound, and then they'll tweak it and turn it to the sound. Your life and your inner life is very much like the same way. If you surround yourself with people who negate you, who devalue and discard you, you'll begin to feel that way. And so the narcissist society oftentimes does create that group think where you have to think like them, be like them, use values like them, even though it's not in embracing of your true self. So for example, you know, Let's go to, everybody goes to McDonald's. Everybody, does this. Everybody does that. And so, even though it's not good for you feel like I have to go along with the crowd. Well, learn and stand up for yourself. Like I was saying in the previous video, when I was a teenager, bringing a box of Special K and fruit into a McDonald's while my family was eating, Big Macs and the pancake meal. I mean, I'm sure McDonald's is global, and we have, international viewers. They're looking at me like crazy, but you know what? I'm the one who did not want to. I wanted to be in touch with the divine. I wanted to flush out all that toxicity, all that negativity. I wanted to think for myself, and I eventually began to go on and continue to think for myself. I created a number of multi-million dollar ideas in the new product market because I was not afraid to think outside of the box. I'm extremely solution oriented. Now, someone who goes along with the group think is feeling uncomfortable being themselves, standing out, being their own into person. I feel so alone. I feel so isolated. Well, guess what? There's a wake-up call. You are meant to be independent. You are meant to be autonomous. You are meant to enliven and embody your own values. You are meant to shake off the gunk, the junk, the groupthink that is leading you into the wrong path. As I've said before, when you're with people who are trying to tell you need to support and only, value these types of people and that they get ahead by devaluing you. You do not need to be around these people. The courage is having the commitment and the understanding and really the inner knowledge, the inner knowing 100% that you are meant to be who you are, where you are, where you are right now, and that you're meant to make those life changes. If you have habituated yourself and filled yourself with negative thoughts, negative food, negative sounds, negative feelings, and you have ground yourself down to the point where you're feeling burned out, it is because you need to go into that deep rest where you're giving yourself a chance to really kind of have an awakening or an epiphany that this life was no longer serving you. You kept on, and in this life, this partner, this person was taking you onto a map where basically a charting you a course in your life where you did not belong, where it's not in your best interest. And that's why you develop, the breakdowns, the fights, the conflict consciousness, constantly feeling like you have to defend and justify yourself. So life really, I really feel it's now bringing you away from that person, that group of people. And if you're fighting it, you're going to have a lot of this tension and anxiety inside. And until you want life and happiness so bad enough that you are like gasping for air, it's as if someone has emerged your head underneath a water faucet and you are gasping for air and you're like, I want to be happy. I want to live. This is it. Until you reach a lot of that point, oftentimes you will not make the changes. You'll continue to, fill your cabinets with chocolate, cookies. You'll fall for the narcissistic advertising. You'll fall for the negative messages about yourself. You won't find a way for you to reinvent yourself, innovate, find your true calling, your true mission. You won't be in attention to the recovery journal. You won't be working your recovery journal. You won't be getting your appointment book. You won't be filling it up with those recovery dates. You won't be resensitizing yourself. As I talk at length about how important it is to surround yourself with positive images, statements, emotions, feelings, people, and sounds, you'll just fall off the wagon. You're wondering why my life is not going anywhere. It's because you don't have the discipline, because you have not held yourself accountable. You're holding a narcissist accountable for your happiness, and there you go backsliding in life again. There you go regressing. And I can guarantee it, you are not working your recovery journal. You're not surrounding yourself with the positive images. You're not keeping your vision ahead of you. You're not paying attention to your I wants, I deserves, your affirmations, your recovery date, taking your recovered self out for 2 hours every day and going and expanding and pushing, those boundaries. You're staying in that self-limiting belief. You've allowed the narcissist to be louder in your life than you. You're having those intrusive thoughts. You're backpedaling. you've allowed the narcissist to gain a clench on you. They have become louder to you in your life than you are in your life. Your voice begins to, muffle and, become non-existent. You become complacent. You become apathetic, and you're doubting yourself. And here comes, the narcissist, well, maybe they're right. Maybe, maybe I am this, maybe I am that. You need to realize that you need to put these tools in place. If you want, this is the education. These are the tools. You need to work on your voice, your senses, surrounding yourself with a positive, opening up those open-ended questions. What do I want to do, be, have, feel, and become? Do you want to feel apathetic laying on the couch? Do you want to feel groggy all the time? Do you want to continue to feed yourself the sugars that make you feel, like crap, carrying a lot of extra weight, negative thoughts that tend to reinforce that? Look and analyze and get that role of metacognition and look at, you have to be brave. You have to be rigorously honest and say, look at what I'm doing to myself. What do I now need to do to change? Go no contact, get in contact with your voice, your feelings, your vision, your mission for your life purpose, and that is yours. That is autonomous, independent, and if the covert narcissist or psychopath has had too much emotional real estate in you, it's time to evict them. It's time to embody yourself, your life, and move it forward. Peace and harmony with you here today. I hope these videos do help. Please share and please subscribe for more great tools, videos, discussion, and support.